everybody. Happy Monday. Happy 2017. And welcome to Collider TV Talk, TV Talk for TV fans. I'm your host, Shanae DeVries, and this is the weekly show where we break down the latest news in the world of television, plus talk about the week or couple months that was in TV. Joining us this afternoon is Josh Makuka.
Oh, Sinead, you're just the best. Happy 2017, everybody. Welcome back to TV Talk. We've been off basically for 2 weeks, but you guys saw our year in review. You also saw the Golden Remotes. Most importantly, the person that wasn't present for those shoots is back with us. And who am I talking about? Sinead DeVries.
Also here is Sasha Pearl Raver.
That's right, y'all. I'm back. And we are coming in so hot. I have refrained from the group text because my present to all y'all are my thoughts. And there's a lot of them percolating.
A thought explosion, a brain explosion.
Oh my God, this is so exciting. I'm so excited to be back.
Also here is David Griffin.
I'm a little bit worried about today's show.
Slow clap.
David Griffin,
slow clap,
guys.
Ladies and gentlemen.
I'm a little worried.
He's back.
And also, if you're on Twitter and you saw Josh McCook, I was in England, I was in London specifically, with the Queen. I know her health hasn't been that well, but she's doing okay. She had time to knight me, yep. So I will now be known as Sir David Edward Griffin from here on out. The yes. Queen is doing okay, folks. She's okay.
Yeah. Sir David Edward Griffin of upstate New Yorkshire.
Yeah, yes. Buffaloshire. Yes. Buffalo Shire.
Lord of positivity, king of all things Anglolic. Anglolic? Sure. And I will be Sasha, Queen of Shade.
And I'll be Josh, Queen of Dummies.
No,
No, you're Queen of Tight Shirts.
Ah, tight shirts, yeah.
So tight shirts.
I may have eaten a little too many Reuben dips over the holidays.
No such
My
thing.
Mom makes a delicious Reuben dip. It's basically a Reuben sandwich. Just dip bread into it. It's incredible.
It's like a French dip, but Reuben.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
You take plain bread, you dip it in a Reuben dip. It's unbelievable. So you wouldn't think Christmas.
Reuben dip's like Thousand Island dressing, right?
Yeah.
Right.
But so is there pastrami in it?
Oh, yeah. Pastrami, sauerkraut, Thousand Island in a dip. And you just take crackers and you eat it. So good.
The culinary knowledge at this table is just incredible.
Yeah. So we went through all kinds of stuff. The Feast of the Seven Fishes was mostly like 4.5 fishes, basically.
All right.
Anyway, we have a big show today, everybody. It's 2017, which means we're going to preview all that we're looking forward to here in the winter season of 2017. We're going to do January, February, March, April, and a little bit of May, because everything else basically in the summertime, we'll do a little summer preview when we get there. Some pilot reviews. We got the OA. We have Troll Hunters. We have Sherlock season premiere. Highs and lows. It's going to be a gigantic show. But before we get into it, let's talk about what we did over the holiday break. Mostly, what shows we watched. David Griffin, let's start with you. What tickled your fancy this holiday season?
I loved Man in the High Castle season 2.
Dude, I binged all of 1
you
and 2.
It?
That was gonna be my binge. Okay. I didn't tell you. It's so good.
I was a little bit worried over the break because we had this group text, but no one was really talking. It was kind of everybody was out doing their own thing.
Family time, man. Everybody was doing family stuff.
I have a fiance now. She like takes time. When she was my girlfriend, I was like, take a hike, but now I got a ring on that.
So thing. I felt like I was in a little bit of my own little bubble there. So I was kind of just watching my shows, sitting there in the TV, and I adored season 2 of Man in the High Castle. Season 1. Was deliberately paced a little too much.
Ah.
That's a new word I learned over the holiday
break. I didn't think it was deliberately paced. I loved season 1.
I thought season 2 was a lot better.
Yeah. Season 2, I will say Man in High Castle, I've been like putting it off. I mean, I'm telling you, I was like, I haven't watched it. I binged that so hard.
Yeah, I guess for those of you who don't know, Man in High Castle is this premise where the Nazis and Japan, the Axis powers won World War II, and now it's the 60s, and now America is divided into the Nazi Reich and the Japan states or Greater Japan, something like Empire, and I don't know, I don't want to spoil anything. There's a lot of weird things going on.
It's a very
If you like The Flash, there's some Flash things going on in there.
What's really cool is it's like a dystopian future that is so creepily accurate, like would be creepily accurate that it's really scary to think about. And I thought this show was going to be a lot more like heavy-handed than it was. It was really, really entertaining. Man in High Castle.
I think I liked season 2 more. I thought it had more fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, it had more fun.
Yeah, way more fun. I don't want to spoil too much.
Yeah, I can't really talk about
it. Man, go ahead and watch Man in High Castle. You would love it.
I've watched it.
Oh.
I didn't love season 1. I haven't gotten into season 2 because season 1 for me was like...
Well, you finished it, though.
Let's go.
Really?
Talk about deliberate pacing.
I felt like that a little bit. I think you'll like season 2 more. It goes.
Okay.
It pushes that. Yeah, it goes.
All right. Sasha, what did you get into?
Oh, my God. You guys, like I said, I have gifts. Backstage on Netflix is amazing. If you loved Fame or Degrassi High, have I got a show for you.
Or if you like Ally and Alex on Disney Channel.
What? Maybe the acting is horrendous. But basically, let me set this up.
Yeah, well, if you can get past horrendous acting.
Hold on. It's Keaton, which is a performing arts school in Canada. But unlike Fame, where there was like acting and dancing and singing, they've got DJs and music. and dancing. I will say there's not quite enough dancing for me, but this show is so perfect for the holidays. It's 23 blissful Canadian minutes where basically you're just watching teen angst and some occasional dancing and then like bad beats from a DJ.
My favorite part in the pilot was when the DJ was like, who uses analog anymore? Nobody knows how to do this. And one goes, he's like, check out my beats. And I was like, oh God, I can't believe someone made me watch this.
I just am really excited.
Why am I playing with these scissors?
I know, I was worried about that. I'm very excited. There's
the primas. Some of those coming up. Yeah.
Now, the primas are so important. And I need more primas. Well, I need more dancing. But honestly, the show, V and C, like it's a little Gossip Girl. Like, Sinead, give my back, girl. Give my back. Give my back, girl.
I will talk about it when it's my turn.
Spoiler alert. It's your turn, Sinead.
All right. So let me tell you about backstage. Backstage is the cheesiest, lamest, most terribly acted 23 minutes of television you will ever watch. And yet, I am 100% hooked on it. I cannot stop watching. It is absurd. And the only reason I keep telling myself to keep watching it is because when I started watching Degrassi, I remember thinking that first season was so bad, but there was something about it that made me watch it. And by like season four, I was the biggest, most diehard Degrassi fan in the world. The first time I went to Canada.
That was also 11 years ago,
I know, Sinead. But the first time I went to Canada was because of my love for Degrassi. Like, that's how much that show. So when you
Degrassi
said.
Degrassi pilgrimage?
That's so real.
Yeah, when you said it was Canadian, it was like Degrassi meets fame, I was like, And I put it on and I was like, first of all, if you're at an elite, the best of the best school, can you be good? Because they're not that great at any of the things that
they're
they do.
They're barely average, including the acting part, which is supposed to be a school for like the dramatic
arts. Yeah. It's amazing because they're like the guy's like, I'm a musical genius. And the one girl's like, oh yeah, they choose like the pilot, for example. So I don't give too much away, just in case.
Yeah.
Just in case you went past the pilot.
They have to pick one girl to be a part of the primas, basically, right? Like the prima in training, ballerina. And every single person that danced in that little audition, it was like, I'm pretty sure if we practice hard enough.
I was going to say, I feel like drunk frat dancing, I would have crushed at that audition.
But that's the thing is, I feel like honestly, the one girl, the blonde girl who didn't get chosen, I feel like it's a plot point later because truly she was the best. And the girl who sings with the weird braids, her voice is actually quite beautiful. And randomly, the one
like Barely Decent Coffee Shop on XM.
No, I like her. Oh my God. And Barely Decent Coffee Shop on XM is totally a channel I would subscribe to. Like, that would be preset number two in my car.
Yeah.
I know one of the teachers, the guy who plays Park, is this delightful gentleman named Chris Hoffman. And when I saw him, I was like, he's so hot. I'm so happy he's on TV.
That's awesome.
Show is. Honestly, here's the other thing that's great. It was the holidays, so I was doing a lot of stuff. I was like baking and wrapping presents and blah, 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 blah. You throw some backstage on, you turn on 1/1000th of your brain, and it washes
it's
over
so
you.
True.
You don't have to really engage.
It's so
it was
true.
So fun.
I know, and that's like the best part about the show, too, is that you don't have to pay that much attention to it because that's the kind of TV I like over the holidays.
But there's also still messages. Like, one of the children has some issues. Like, there's drama.
Oh, shocker.
They're like 11 years old.
David Griffin is holding his tongue here because he is pissed that he even watched the pilot.
So the group text was going on a little bit last night talking about Sherlock. I'm like, oh, Sherlock's on tonight. Yeah. And then Josh's like, oh, I'm busy watching backstage. So I'm
sending
like, okay.
Screenshots of the show, making it look like it's some sort of like perfect, like crafted TV.
So Sasha, you know, very intelligent woman. I trust Sasha. I said, let me take a break from Sherlock. Let me check out this backstage. So I get like 5 minutes in. I'm like, oh my God. I mean, so like it has that like mockumentary kind of thing, like a Parks and Rec or The Office. When they're interviewing the kids, you can see them thinking about remembering their lines. They're like,
and then they're like, and now I turn my head.
It's so bad. It is one of the worst shows I've ever seen. I'm sorry. It's awful.
It's really
bad. Do not
watch
this. Do not.
I will say, over the holidays, my parents took all of our VHSs and put them on DVDs. That's all behind my family is. Pittsburgh just got DVDs like 3 weeks ago, so we're pretty excited.
Oh, what's crazy is Netflix actually recommended it for me.
Yeah.
It said, David, this is probably a 4-star rating for you. I'm like, oh no. Oh. I put that bad boy down to 1. I put my rating on there. Oh my goodness.
So I will say my parents had my fourth grade play, on DVD and we watched like the first 20 minutes. It was brutal, but I will say, me in fourth grade was better than like 90% of the kids on backstage. Yeah,
fine, but it's still fun to watch.
Oh, man.
All right,
okay, let's go into our, thank you all for watching television over the break. I really appreciate it. I'm so excited to be back here with all of you talking television because it just wasn't the same. Those 2 Mondays over the break, they just weren't so the same without you
agreed.
Guys. Let's talk about Trollhunters on Netflix, just dropped over the holiday. And Guillermo del Toro, I don't love animation, which is why we don't talk a ton about anime or stuff. I know you do. It's not that I don't like it. It's just I don't watch a lot of it. I watch the pilot and then binge the next 7. I love this.
Yeah,
this is
great.
So much fun. Yeah. It's so Guillermo del Toro. Has like that Big Hero 6 feel to it. Mm. It's so lovable. All the characters are well-defined. Even after like the first 5 minutes, I was like, I'm on board. Sign me up for this show. It's not only good for parents, it's great for kids. It has a really cool lesson involved in the whole thing. And I just think if you are a fan of Guillermo del Toro or if you're a fan of animation, this show is 100% for you.
Also, too, every episode kind of makes you sad because at the end of every episode, it ends with like, in memory of Anton Yelchin, who of course, tragically passed this year, which is sad. But the voice acting is incredible. You have Kelsey Grammer and the animation, it looks like you're watching a movie.
Yeah.
Like I was like, oh, animation on TV, especially American animation, looks solid, but it's never like on the level, of course, if you go see a Pixar movie. This actually looks like DreamWorks could put it on the theaters. It looks that good. And every episode, it's not like they solved it. Every episode leads into the next. It's a big story. Mark Guggenheim, who writes in The Flat, who writes on Arrow and Legends of Tomorrow, also writes on the show, too. He's one of the producers. It's a very well-done show.
I have to say, in terms of pilots, this one is one of the smartest I've seen in a very long time.
Yeah.
It has that amazing way of like hooking you in, not just to the character, although as soon as the character started talking and I heard Anton Yelchin's voice, because I knew nothing besides Guillermo del Toro. Mm-hmm. I was very sad for a second. Then I was like, okay, get back into the show. Right. The first 3 minutes are genius for setting up the world, and the last 2 minutes, smartest pilot presentation I've seen since This Is Us in terms of like hooking you in and being like, damn, I gotta watch more of this.
Right. Like you figured,
so well done.
I don't want to spoil anything, but you figure based on voice that so and so could be a villain, but the way he acts as the person, I'm like trying not to give anything away here, is he's so lovable and kind. You're like, I couldn't see that coming.
Didn't see it coming.
Yeah. Sinead, what did you think of Trollhunters?
I loved it. It's so well done. Like the animation, like you said, is awesome. Mm-hmm. And I was telling them backstage, the first couple of minutes when they're like Arcadia and they show Suicide Bridge and the 110, I was just like, whoa, because it looks exactly like my backyard. And I was like, this is awesome. like legit. And the first person I thought of was you actually, because I was like, huh. Look, it's at home. And it's so well done. Like, I was like, whoa, I felt maybe only because I'm so familiar with that part of town, but also, like, it was like, wow, this is exactly the way it looks, and it's so well done. And Big Hero 6 was the first thing that came to mind.
I love that movie
especially
so much.
With the trolls, and the way that they are presented as well. But, man, there's something about the show I think is so, like, clever and smart that it's like I haven't even fully tapped into how good it is just yet, and I have only watched like 3 episodes.
Humor drama. I can't wait to introduce this to my niece and nephew
and
tell my brother, hey,
that's
make
what
him,
I was thinking.
Have him watch Trollhunters so we can share this together, because I will buy them Trollhunter toys. I will get all that kind of stuff because this. I just fell in love with the show.
Yeah, it's brilliant, and also it's rare that I actually laugh out loud at a show. Mm-hmm. I laughed out loud at the show multiple times, and it's got like you guys are talking about Big Hero 6, but it also has some great classic sort of Excalibur stuff. Mm-hmm. It's got some brilliant How to Train Your Dragon stuff.
Yeah, DreamWorks. Yeah.
I mean, it's just beautiful. And Ron Perlman, who also does a voice, it's so, so good. Mm-hmm. Kelsey Grammer, that introduction of his character made my heart do happy circles and jumps and
donuts. It starts talking, and I go to myself, holy cow, wait, is that Kelsey Grammer? I had to stop, check the IMDb.
No, you went, is that Frasier?
But the funny part about it is he's like, he ends basically his first talk is like, and if you calculate this perfectly. And I was like, oh, so he's Frasier. It's perfect. Because he's got that gravitas and that voice all around, just so well done. This is, it is
26
episodes. I'll be done with this by the week's end. I mean,
it's
just
like 20
so
minutes each.
20
minutes this is
each.
Just part one, as it says. So I'm guessing we're going to get a part two sometime.
Yeah.
Hopefully soon.
Just really, really well done.
But that was my question. Having only watched the pilot, what happens because now you don't have Anton Yelchin?
Yeah, where do you go?
What do you do?
Well, at least after part. Well, I assume they got all the recordings done at least for the part one, hopefully, before he passed. So
I don't know.
I'm on episode four or five, and it's still his voice as far as I can tell, but I hope so. I don't know.
I mean, you saw Rogue One. There are people that can imitate other people's
voices.
That's
true. Yeah.
All right, fine.
There you go. Okay, let's talk the Sherlock season premiere. Sasha's favorite show ever of all time.
No, favorite actor ever.
Oh, that's right. Benedict Cumberbatch is your favorite actor. With this, we know. Okay, I lied to you. I did watch the whole thing because I wanted to see you disappointed.
That's awesome.
Here's the thing that I got from the episode one of the season premiere of the that I just missed this show so much. I love Benedict Cumberbatch as Sherlock. I love Martin Freeman as Watson. This is one of those shows where it goes so far. There's such a long break between seasons because these guys are so busy and these things take so long to produce that when it does come back, it's like an old friend. You just pick up right where you left off. You tell old stories. Mm-hmm. You feel old things. I'm so ready for Sherlock season premiere. Like any Sherlock, there are so many seeds planted in the pilot. I might have to go back and watch this again.
No, it's like it's a movie.
Yeah.
Every episode they've ever released is around 88 to 90 minutes long. I love about PBS. Thank you, PBS. They run the episodes commercial free.
Yeah. Well,
donate to PBS. Public broadcast.
Get your tote bag.
Yep. Donate. They also have a new spokesperson. No more Laura Linney.
Oh,
it was another
it
guy.
It was Ewan McGregor.
No, it's not Ewan. It's like...
Oh, Ewan was on Channel 50. Version? Yeah, I got Ewan McGregor at the end.
Oh, I had somebody else.
It was just voiceover, though.
Oh, yeah. Well, anyway,
Did you have Lin-Manuel Miranda? Because he's been doing a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
Was it Lin-Manuel?
Maybe.
What movie did I just see where Laura Linney was like a mom...
That narrows it down.
Laura Linney,
a
mom.
I'll look it up. Okay, but anyway, right, continue.
Yeah, so
90 minutes, no commercials.
90 minutes, no commercials. Excellent return.
Oh, Sully. She's the wife. There you go.
Oh, Sully, yeah. Oh, right.
My bad. Thanks, guys. Sorry I ruined TV Talk. And cut back to 2017. Thank you guys so much. David Griffin, carry on.
Sherlock.
Sir David Edward Griffin of upstate New York.
Series 4 of Sherlock was very well done. I like the premise of Moriarty. I'm not going to go into huge spoilers, but like, is he back? Is he not back? Is he playing tricks from the dead? Yeah. Is he still really alive? And then, of course, what this episode does, it's not spoiling too much, is we go more into Mary.
Yeah.
We go more into Watson's wife and what she's going through. I love that actress. That's actually Martin Freeman's partner for a while. They have a couple kids together in real life.
Oh,
I think that's why they have
such
good chemistry together.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. She's also on another great show called Mr. Selfridge. I was on for 4 seasons as well. I'm sure Josh watched that one.
I knew Mr. Selfridge well.
But no, I like
some of his clothes.
Like you said, when those guys are together, they're awesome. I remember one year in the Emmys, they each won awards. Martin Freeman won for Fargo, and you had Cumberbatch winning for Sherlock. These guys just are such good actors. I don't know if every episode's perfect. There's some episodes, like especially the second episode in every season, always seems to be the weakest for me. But I feel like when they're together on screen, it's magic, and I have fun watching them, even though sometimes I think the plots kind of run all over the place. Mm-hmm. But I still have fun just because they're so good together.
How many episodes is each season? Six?
Three. Just three.
Oh, yeah. Damn.
So three 90-minute episodes, and that's it.
Cool.
Yeah, that's it.
And you have... one of my favorite things about Sherlock, and one thing they do so well, is they put modern technology like it's never really been seen before on television. So it makes texting seem really, everything is so, like, blur. It's like old pop-up video from back in the day.
I also like, too, how, like, when they'd have a note, and you'd see the note, and they'd pass it to somebody, and they'd turn it and read it. On our image, it would flip, and you'd see it backwards, which is really cool, too.
Yeah,
I like that.
Yeah. Sasha?
I love the bated breath. Look, David's face right now, he's literally like...
Tell us.
So I had never watched an episode of Sherlock until this morning. I had not seen a single episode. I had not watched even a moment of it. So my first episode was this morning, last night's premiere. I effing loved every second of it.
See?
It is the best
even
version.
Even your boy Cumberbatch?
Even my boy Cumberbatch. Ooh. First of all, I'm like, how does he memorize all them lines and say them so quick?
Yeah.
This is the best version of British I Solved It ever. Like, and the fact that they don't solve all of the pieces, that there are all these tendrils that are left, it is so exquisitely shot. Oh my God, it's so beautiful.
Yeah.
I thought that the way that they put everything into, the writers of the show are brilliant.
You know, it's Mark Gatiss, it's Gatiss who is Mycroft.
Yeah,
he's a writer. He wrote that episode.
Genius. Yeah. The writing is phenomenal. The direction was
unbelievable. It's modern Shakespeare.
It is modern Shakespeare. I thought that I didn't know Martin Freeman was even in the show. So when he popped up, I was like, oh, dope.
Yeah.
I totally loved it. There was one thing. Let me get a spoiler alert. Spoiler alert. One thing that really bothered me about the episode was the introduction of a love interest that made me feel like something that happened at the end of the episode lost some of its power because I was like, well, why is there a side chick?
Well, Zed is now, he never, well, I guess in his...
And do we trust that side chick? Because already I'm like, that...
Well, here's the thing with Sherlock. He always has, he's so not really like the loving kind, if you will. He's not, you know, out there like trying to meet somebody. He's almost asexual to a certain extent, but he always has a love interest that is maybe more in love with him than he is with her, or vice versa. Like, it's
no. He's talking. She's talking about Martin Freeman.
Oh, yeah. Martin Freeman.
Martin Freeman.
God.
Yeah.
Like, oh, okay.
No. Yeah. Well, you'll notice, Sasha, is Sherlock. What they typically do every season is they have a first episode. A second episode is kind of like a side episode. It doesn't tie into the rest of them. And the third episode ties back into the first episode.
Was that a time jump or no? No, because we saw...
Right. So what they'll do...
It's almost like season two of The Wire.
Right. So it will tie in with each other. It's just that usually you have to get to the third episode before you see how it all wraps up.
Got it.
So it will wrap up. It'll wrap up. Yeah.
Okay.
They won't just leave it. They solved it and then move on.
So maybe what that was that like is a future experience.
Right.
Okay. Because not knowing that, watching it, I was like, but what?
No, we'll see that play out.
Okay. Yeah, but I thought the show was phenomenal. I mean, I am totally into it. I set a recording for the rest of them. I thought it was phenomenal.
Yeah. Okay. We got Sasha on board.
Totally.
Ready to go.
I was worried. I know. I was like, oh, man.
Don't be worried.
Sasha's
I love
on
it.
His next one, though.
Okay.
I'm worried.
Here's the thing.
You should be.
No. Okay.
Yeah, you should be.
Next up here, we're talking the OA. And I believe all of us watched the pilot, Sinead included. Okay. Besides the fact, maybe, Cody, we should throw up a spoiler on this one. So if you've watched the OA, we're only going to talk about the pilot, but I'm like 5 or 6 episodes in. I will say the only thing that I don't like about this show thus far is the nosebleed. It reminds me too much of Eleven in Stranger Things. Other than that, I love this show. Britt, the main girl, I have the biggest crush on this actress. I think she's absolutely fantastic.
Writes all her own stuff. She's been in Sundance.
Yeah.
And, yeah, she writes all her own stuff.
This show is what I hoped it would be, and I just, there's something so mysterious and fun about it that I'm just totally hooked on this show. I can see the disdain.
I'm
going
to say something
there
to get Sasha upset. This show is better than Stranger Things.
Thank you, Jacob.
What are you guys out of your minds?
Yes.
Are you kidding me? Okay, we've got a mysterious woman who comes in dramatically, whose nose bleeds, who may or may not have powers, who brings together a disparate group of people, except that all the people suck. This show bit my cooter in the worst way. I want to punch Britt Marley in the face. This show made me so angry. It's literally Stranger Things if Stranger Things had no originality. It's Stranger Things if the only thing you had was the nosebleed. This show is so dumb.
No,
and I don't care about any of the characters.
It's not.
And I watched 2 episodes, and at the end of the second episode, I was like, F this in its F hole, in its penis hole. I want to stick. This show was like taking a toilet brush to the front of your urethra.
Whoa.
It was so grating and awful.
Ew.
Britt Marling.
We might have to edit that.
I can't even.
This
show was horrible.
This is.
And everybody's talking about how unsatisfying the last episode is.
Nope.
Why are people into the show? This show is so dumb.
It's not
dumb.
The
science of this show
is
ridiculous.
It's not. You think that the science to Stranger Things is more than the OA?
I think the world creation is better in Stranger Things. I think the characters. I care more about Barb than anybody in this thing. Anybody.
Before the comment section blows up, I want to say this.
I really, not on me
for saying it's better than Stranger Things. I enjoyed Stranger Things. Stranger Things is member berries.
Yes.
Remember the 80s? Remember Dungeons and Dragons? Remember kids playing in their basements? Remember E.T.?
Yeah.
Remember Close Encounters of the Third Kind? Yep. Yeah. I remember that stuff. This show is not safe.
These kids have issues. Stranger Things?
No, remember like when like girls are questioning if they're a boy when they're like 10 years old? Like these kids have real issues. Stranger Things kids are safe.
Yep.
Those kids are come from nice suburban households, the families. I mean, they have some issues.
Well,
but
so you've got the teenage boy who's overdeveloped to the point that he looks like a college football player, who's got issues because he punches a wall but has no real backstory and isn't interesting at all. You've got the kid who's questioning their sexuality. Ooh, way to go hot button. Then you've got the 2 other randoms and the 1 woman who would never show up ever in a million years. That made absolutely no sense. This show makes no sense. This show is dumb. This show sucks. My poo.
I'm just like, you are 100% wrong.
No.
I usually like try and argue with it, but you're so wrong, it's offensive.
So here's the thing. Because we talked about backstage earlier, they're going to try to throw
backstage
into this. Backstage
are you
is
serious?
A guilty pleasure. I know the acting is bad. I understand that that's not something you actually like dive into and enjoy with great writing, like Sherlock. With the OA, I felt manipulated. I thought the acting was
so good.
And the central conceit of the story tell me that at the end of the first episode, you care. Cobster, did you care at the end of the first episode? No, you didn't. See, he's walking away.
Cobster doesn't know what happened. He just walked in. He doesn't know what's going
Let's hear what Sinead DeFries
has to
say.
When they start rolling the credits, I'm like, are you kidding? That is such a manipulation.
Loved it. Because it's supposed to be an 8-part fucking miniseries.
Ooh,
go ahead,
he said
Sinead.
An F.
My bad. Sorry, guys.
I liked it.
A little bit angry, though.
I liked it. I don't know. I think you're wrong. I do think you're wrong. I think some of the things you're saying, a lot of people agree with, because as much as I thought everyone was going to be on board with the show, I have seen a lot of people siding with Sasha, especially since we did just get Stranger Things.
Yeah.
And there are a lot of similarities or like, that just make it makes the originality, it depletes the originality of this show. So I agree with that. But I did like it. I've only watched the pilot, so I have no idea. I'm not like 100% totally hooked on it, mm-hmm. but I like it enough to definitely keep watching, and I've told people to watch it, so I think it's definitely worth
it.
Shot.
See, I loved it, and I'm hooked on it.
Did you get to the end?
No, not yet.
I finished it. I binged it.
What I've heard like are the days. Middle, like episode four, five and six are good. And everything else is like a little weird. And then I hear the final episode just makes you go, why did I watch
this? But I think the thing is so many shows nowadays play it safe. To give one thing, one thing I'm surprised
spoiler,
by hearing from
there.
You, Sasha, and I'm not going to spoil, is that at least this show doesn't mean it has to work for you. I'm not trying to say you have to like it. But at least this show takes risks. I don't
what
think this
risks?
Is a safe.
What
how
risks
is this a safe show?
Take?
This is not going to make it on AMC, on FX. This show
why?
Is not.
Why? Because it's so boringly
it's
paced?
No,
it's plotted?
Not.
Are you kidding me?
It's not.
I'm going to leave my front door open in the freezing cold, and nobody's going to be like, damn, my house is cold AF. I should go check on my underage child who's gone all night. Are you kidding me?
They're from Michigan.
I'm gonna
they're used to the cold.
I'm going
to
go
their
get
their parents
my...
are all kind of messed up. The one kid's mom didn't really have one. The other kid's.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous. It would never happen. And in this little community, you think that people wouldn't notice? There's not some sort of like neighborhood watch that doesn't notice that there's this one kid running drugs out of the... It is unfathomably dumb. And also, all of their eyes are open. She's like, close your eyes. All of their eyes are open by the end of it. They're all peeking, and none of them learn anything
That's
by the end of
the night. That's
the
problem you had with it was peeking?
My problem with it is they sit and they listen to this boring story that goes
Are you kidding
nowhere.
Me?
Are you kidding me? Why do they care? Why do they care about her?
Because she's so charming and she has this ability for people to
want... I wanted to punch her in the face forever.
The reason why they care about her is because all these kids are coming from all these... I hate saying the word broken homes. That's such a general term. They're coming from bad situations at home. Yeah. They're struggling with... They need some kind of identity, some kind of friendship. And I think at the end of this, I'm not going to spoil what happens at the end, but one thing that this proves is that being together is better than being alone. It might go out about this weird way with there's movements and dancing and all this weird stuff.
I've heard about that, and that to me is
about But I think it's like, about bleh. Being together, and they're stronger together, and they need each other to survive, to get through the horrible, I don't know, their horrible lives
right now.
Right,
but if that's the central conceit, watch Friday Night Lights.
Yeah.
I mean, give me a break.
I like it. I like
Whatever.
It. There we go.
Contentious.
Divisive. Starting off 2017 hot.
I knew that was going to happen.
Speaking,
I've been waiting for it.
Speaking of 2017, here we go. Sinead DeFries is going to lead us all the way through. We're going to talk all of the premiere dates of these shows, tell you if we're excited, if we're not excited, a little blurb perhaps, you know, if we'll watch it, if we watch it, yada, yada, yada. One thing leads to another. The lovely, the tan is going to take us through.
Oh,
2017.
That was the first one of
2017.
She's
our 10.
She's a
10. She's a 17.
She's
a
10.
Aw, you guys are so sweet. All right, so starting off this week on NBC, we have Emerald City.
I think this may be the best trailer I've seen for a network show in a year.
Sure.
And I'm really interested in it. I'm definitely going to watch.
I think it looks really interesting, too. I like the idea of like a new version of Oz.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Like
Sinead?
Yeah, and plus, like, NBC, I just feel like I have a newfound love for NBC.
After This Is Us.
Yeah, so
I'm kind of ready for Fairy Tales. I fell out of Once Upon a Time, which I watched for a few seasons. I'm ready for something new.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Uh-huh.
All right, what's next?
One Day at a Time, Netflix. Actually, haven't seen anything about this.
Is this One Day at a Time, like, One Day at a Time?
Yes,
one
it's
day
a remake
a
of One Day at a Time with a Cuban-American family. I read the blurb about it.
One
I don't know if you have to... See, here's the thing. Somebody tweeted at me today that Fuller House got a season 3.
Yeah.
I can't watch Fuller House because when I watched Full House, like backstage, I was like, well, the acting sucks, but I'm 10. Now that I'm like, now that I'm an adult, I'm like, I can't watch backstage.
It's not the same.
It's not the same. Fuller House, the same thing. Like, if you don't have Uncle Jesse saying, have mercy every episode, why am I watching? One Day at a Time, I'm the same way. Leave, let be. Let B, yeah. let B.
I don't know, though, because those shows, even though a lot of us are like, ooh, why is this still happening? There is such a cult following. That's why Gilmore Girls almost broke the internet, and Fuller House will never stop making seasons, apparently, because they have people who dying over things like that. So the whole nostalgic factor totally works for those shows.
I don't disagree with you, Shanae. Member berries. Well said. Member berries.
All right. Taboo on FX.
Yes.
January 10th.
Can't wait.
This is the one I'm, besides a couple that we're going to talk about in a little bit, this is the one I'm most excited for.
Okay. I group texted these fools and I think Christmas. And I was like, you guys, I have the first two episodes. Yeah. I have not watched them because that's how much I love you guys because I'm saving it.
I said party at Sasha's and then nobody really...
That's how much, but I cannot wait. Oh. So when we're off the air, let's discuss.
Let's plan something.
Because I've been saving it.
It's going to be the dopeness.
The final season of Workaholics.
Yeah, one of my favorite comedies of the last 5 years. A couple good buddies of mine, we used to do stand-up together back in the day. This show kind of changed. It's the only show that people like really watching on Comedy Central.
Yeah.
And there's something just so wrong.
People watch Broad City.
Oh, Broad City. Yeah. I always forget Broad City. I'm sorry. I always think that Broad City's and Key and Peele. But those shows,
R.I.P. It feels
like those shows are like bigger than Comedy Central. Does that make sense?
Totally.
But Workaholics kind of changed the game. I remember making my dad watch an episode and be like, what in the hell is this? And I was like, yeah, it's really just for our generation. But final season, they five seasons. Awesome
good
stuff.
That trailer like that they show, I've only seen it once, the other day, actually. But it made me sad.
Yeah.
It was so not Workaholics for me.
I know.
But it was like such a cute, sweet, simple, like final season. It was like quiet.
It's tough.
Yeah.
All right, what's next?
All right, Lemony Snicket's Netflix, January 13th.
This looks so good.
Yeah.
The trailers for this continue to look so good. I
mean,
can't
we
wait.
Talked about this, right? Yeah. Like how we were so disappointed with the movie not just taking off.
But NPH going to crush it.
I can't wait.
Yeah. Apparently came out in an interview and said this is going to be way darker than people think.
Oh, cool. Excited. Yeah, cool.
Great.
Cool.
Nice.
Yeah.
All right, Amazon on January 13th, we have Sneaky Pete.
Yeah. I watched the pilot. It was solid.
Okay.
It was solid. I saw it came, Amazon does their pilot season. It's like over a year and a half ago now. I like Giovanni Ribisi. Ever since I saw Boiler Room, I've always found him to be an interesting actor. I feel like he's kind of underused. I don't use him enough, but this could be worth a shot.
I'm on board. It sort of looks like Matchstick Men a little bit, but with
you didn't watch the pilot?
No, not yet.
Oh, okay.
I want to binge.
Now, if you can check it out.
All right, cool.
I haven't heard anything about it. I do like Giovanni Ribisi, but I love the Boiler Room. That's a nice throwback.
Yeah,
dude.
I love that movie. That's one of my favorites.
Man,
Homeland is still on TV.
Yes. Yes, it is becoming like Homeland is becoming more and more accurate of the times that we are dealing with. I love Homeland, bringing it back.
Okay,
I'm the only one.
Yep,
I tried. Okay, I did.
I watched it for like four seasons.
Yeah,
I think.
And I feel like it was just like, all right, she has one tone of voice, and it is my least favorite tone of voice.
She cries a lot, and her eyes are real big.
Oh, man.
If you ever want to talk to anybody about it, my parents are readily available.
Yeah, same here. My parents too.
Yes. People watch. That's why Showtime just keeps renewing.
It's going to be live from the DeFries and the Pearl Raver household.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. The Young Pope on HBO.
Yes. Oh, I can't wait for more episodes. Here's the only thing that's weird for me about this show is, so I get together with my best friend every Sunday night, and we have family dinner, and we always watch a show. But this show is going to be Sundays and Mondays. It's going to be an hour episode every Sunday and every Monday. Mm. So we've already figured out a schedule. We're like, okay, so we'll do Sunday the first time, then we'll do the Monday and then the Sunday, and then we'll do this Monday and then the Sunday, and then we'll do the Monday and then the Sunday, and then for the last episode, we'll do that we'll do like 3 hours in one. But I just can't wait. I mean, this show is so beautiful. The pilot was just phenomenal.
Yeah, I'm jealous. Everybody in the UK already saw it. They're done.
Can't
yeah, they
wait
finished
for
it.
This.
I'm so
this
excited
is gonna
for
be
the Young
excellent.
Pope. This is what all you guys think that Westworld is. This is what I think Young Pope's going to be. Going to change it up.
Change the game.
Except
they can't do a second season. It's a miniseries.
Oh, that's all right.
Eight episodes, right?
I wish they wouldn't do a second season of Westworld. I get it. They're robots. All right, what's next,
Sinead? Six on the History Channel?
Yeah, so Walton Goggins replaced Joe Manganiello.
Yes.
It's about, like, it's basically The Revenant, but in a TV show. It's about the fur trade. And Walton Goggins, not that many people watch.
Wait, no. This is
Navy
SEALs.
This is SEAL Team 6.
Oh, sorry, this is my bad.
Yeah, that's Navy SEALs, yeah.
SEAL Team 6.
Yeah.
SEAL Team 6, and they're all basically kind of what Strike Force was.
Yeah.
But this is going to be a six-part miniseries on history. They something like 30 or 40 Navy SEALs consulted on the show.
Damn.
Which is
it looks good.
Incredible.
I've been, watching Vikings on history, and they keep showing clips and behind the scenes. And it looks interesting. I love Walton Goggins.
Ugh.
Ever since, like, I saw him on The Shield, of course, but even Justified, he's such a good actor.
And nobody watched Vice Principals but me, but he was.
I watched it.
Oh, did you? He was fantastic.
You know who else loves Vikings? Anderson Cooper.
Anderson Cooper likes Vikings.
CNN on New Year's Eve.
Wow.
You guys could hang out.
That's a classy dude right there.
All right.
Baskets on FX, January 19th.
The previews look incredible. Louis Anderson won. He's going to win the Golden Globe. I'm so excited for Baskets to come back.
Frontier, that hits Netflix on January 20th.
That's the one about the fur trade. That's what Jason Momoa.
The Momoa replace.
Oh, did somebody say Momoa?
In fur.
Momoa in fur.
Jason Momoa wearing fur?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, I'm so in.
I'm so in. Oh, 2017 just got
okay,
so much.
I watched this show that's on Sundance, and I don't even know if it's getting a season
Red
three.
Road.
Red Road. He's so good in Red Road.
Yeah,
oh,
Jason
man.
Momoa.
I love the Momoes.
Mimosa.
A Mimosa.
A Mimosa.
What would be in a Mimosa? Would it just be like...
Just sexy man juice. Just bedroom.
Momoa sweat and a little bit of orange juice, splash champagne.
Oh, God, he's my faves.
A little bit of whiskey on top.
I just want to climb him like a beanstalk. Just a giant...
I'm in. Sign me up.
Beanstalk.
All right, what's next, Sinead?
Outsiders.
Yes, WGN America, it's coming back.
Here. I get emails about that effing show all the time.
It's so good. And what I didn't realize, I mean, I knew they shot a lot of it in Pittsburgh. They told me where the set was, drove around it when I was there over the holiday. It's in a place called Millvale, Pennsylvania. It's not close to my house, it's about 40 minutes away. If you drive around, it is awesome.
Just seeing the sights while he's at
home. Yes.
Sweet.
All right, Jess.
The Path is back on January 25th. On
wait, this is getting kind of fast. Didn't we just watch that show?
No, it's been so
March?
Long.
No, I mean, I like it, but...
April. April. It came out April 10th.
Yeah. We had, just started TV Talk.
Dang, we missed a long time.
It was one of our first pilot reviews.
Yeah.
Path.
Claire Sinead has been in...
She's waiting for it.
You guys, The Path, I'm obsessed.
Yeah.
It is so good. Hugh Dancy... He just can have all of it. He can have all of me. I will give all of me to him. Okay.
She's singing John Lennon.
I was gonna say.
That's how we're doing.
I was like, why does this sound familiar?
Actually, Sinead auditioned with all of me to get into Backstage in Canada.
Amazing.
I didn't make it.
I'm gonna audition with all of me to get into Frontier.
They didn't cast me on
Sinead
that TV
would make
show.
Backstage so much better.
So much
I would
better.
Watch.
Oh my God.
So
wait, I don't know if this is on the rundown. Did anybody watch the Star pilot over the break?
Oh no.
No.
Star Lee Daniels' new
show it's Empire.
Is it Empire spinoff? Does it take place in the same universe?
It's basically a girl from Pittsburgh.
Yeah, the three girls
who is like in foster care. She gets her sister and gets this other girl, and they go off to form a girl group in Atlanta. I enjoyed it tremendously. You've got Queen Latifah, Lenny Kravitz, Benjamin Bratt, this girl who I'd never seen before who's fantastic. The
you know
music
what I forgot
is great.
This is totally off topic, but you know our buddy from Flesh and Bone who was the instructor? He's in Rogue One.
Oh, yeah.
There
yeah.
There you go.
But oh, my God. Yeah, Star was fun.
Okay, Star.
Anyway.
Okay, throw it in there.
Side note.
All right, here comes a big one.
Riverdale.
Boom. Yeah. This is going to be what I'm hoping backstage.
Are you air guitaring?
I'm air guitaring. Yeah.
Slapping
the bass.
It's
actually air bass.
Slapping the bass.
And then I play one of those mini guitars up here sometimes.
I saw something that was like, the shows we expect to be canceled in 2017, and Riverdale was one of them, and I was like, excuse me.
This is not No Tomorrow or whatever those other.
Yeah, that's
not
going to be canceled. I can't. Can't
frequency.
Wait.
It's not going to happen.
God, I
okay,
hope so.
Sinead, what's next?
Watch it be terrible. Even better.
No
backstage.
We're going to be Riverdale apologists until the very end.
Totally. Z, the beginning of everything, January 27th.
Yeah, I'm going to say Z, though. I don't
so
care about it.
I'm so bummed about this. So, Zelda Fitzgerald, this is the life of Zelda Fitzgerald.
Yeah,
we talked
F.
about
Scott's
it.
Great
oh,
on the
right,
TV
right,
talk
right,
that you
were
here,
yeah.
unfortunately.
So, it's Christina Ricci.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I just, this is such a great topic. I mean, there's a bunch
making
of movies,
two movies
that are in development
yeah.
right now. One with Scarlett Johansson, one with Jennifer Lawrence. Mm-hmm. But I feel like this show looks like the chintziest version of the tale that should be, I mean, is really interesting. It would be like great to dive into. I just, I don't know.
Why? Yeah. Just like, why is everyone doing it?
It's that thing where you get like Deep Impact and you get Armageddon at the same time. Something just
hits
the zeitgeist.
Well, it's like you did Capote and then you did Capote again.
Right.
So we got the Prestige and the Illusionist.
Yes.
The same,
well, there's also The Crown and Victoria, which I saw.
But those are both excellent.
Well, I was
in
watching.
Their own way.
Sir Edward.
Yes.
Was excellent, yes.
All right. What's next, Sinead?
Black Sails, the final salesman.
See what I did there?
Yeah, it's good. It's real good.
You're welcome.
They're puns.
I feel like I can picture you writing these notes like...
Yeah, that's good. They're gonna like that one.
Maybe a little bit.
I'm gonna tell him that I didn't watch all of it, and then I'm gonna tell him right before we start that I did watch all of it. He's gonna love it.
You know who's Black so Sailor. Exciting for Black Sales is Kara Warner. Kara Warner, who is David one of like Griffin's the great fiance. Dividers in our friendship. She's like, how have you not watched the show? And I'm like, I don't have stars.
Yeah, Black Sales.
You don't have stars?
I had it, and then we canceled it, so now I just go
over. So instead,
she just
watches Star. See what it did there, guys?
Wow.
All right, guys, that's 2017 houses. For this guy.
No, I can't wait for the final season of Black Sails. It's all about the rise of Long John Silver. This is going to be great.
It almost, you know what I keep thinking is Black Sails is going to have like a shared universe.
Not the restaurant, not the restaurant.
Black Sails is going to have a shared universe with Taboo. That's what I keep thinking.
That'd be sweet.
That'd be awesome.
Also, Long John Silver is the restaurant.
He's gross.
Gross.
Totally gross.
So
brought
gross.
To you by Long John Silver.
They have hush puppies.
Long Dong Silver, the 70s porn star. Now that's another
They have like all like the finest seafoods. They'll advertise.
It's all fried that too. Everything's
like
deep fried.
That's where you went for the Feast of Seven Fishes, which is why it was only 4.5 inches. That's what you do.
You're welcome.
Gross. All right. The Expanse on Sci-Fi.
Yeah, that's David Griffin.
This will be the best night of my life. February 1st, I'll be glued to the television. We have The Expanse. 2 hours of The Expanse and 1 hour of The 100, which is my favorite show on the CW, hands down. So it's going to be a great night.
Party.
Well, party at the Griffin household.
Party at the Griffin household.
2 hours?
Jeez.
Why?
That's just... Right,
well, David Griffin just spoiled the next one, which is The 100.
Oh, so, I'm sorry.
No, that's okay.
I went ahead.
Why don't we go to the next one then?
Powerless on NBC.
We've been talking about this for a while. I'm really excited.
I'm
the only
sold.
One on here.
Yeah, I think I'm less sold than I was before. And also, like, why has it been in development for, like, 17 years?
And they haven't really been, like... I don't know. I feel like they
They're
haven't
not
really
pushing it.
Pushing it. Yeah, it's been quiet.
Yeah.
Okay, let's maybe pick this up a little bit.
Superior Donuts? What's that about?
It's about
donuts.
It's a family running a donut shop and like dealing with like a sort of bougie world around them.
Yeah,
interesting.
I'm saying no.
I do like donuts though.
I do too, but no. I
think I'm with you on that one and the next one too.
Training Day on CBS.
Yeah, I don't know why we do this.
Oof, I have no interest. Yeah. Next.
I love Lethal Weapon.
Unless Denzel's
in Lethal Weapon, and then
weird. Santa Clarita Diet.
This I'm into. Drew Barrymore on television.
It's on Netflix.
Yeah.
It's Drew Barrymore, and it's basically like. You know, they're dealing with the bougie society of Santa Clarita, California.
Yeah,
it's
awesome. Cool.
Interesting.
I'm into it.
Is it a documentary?
No.
But it could be.
It's a comedy.
I do love Drew Barrymore.
Me too.
I watched all of her movies over the break.
How to Lose a Guy in 50 Days. What's
that's Kate Hudson.
That's Kate Hudson.
No, 50 First Dates.
50 First Dates, I watched that
and
every Saturday.
And E.T.
Never Been Kissed.
The best.
Ugh.
The best.
Amazing.
The best. Michael Vartan, get woof.
Okay. I know she gets hit by an egg and it's like really sad because like, you shouldn't be a high school bully, but I did that to my buddy. Not a girl. I did it to a guy. Like,
I thought you were going to say I did that.
No. We used to do that to like our buddies as like a funny joke to friends. Like, we're going to pick you up and then we'd launch eggs at them. Never Been Kissed, though. No, it was so fun.
I got a crush on her. What was that scandalous movie? Was she like in Poison Ivy? That
movie? Poison Ivy 3, I think.
Wait, she's in the first one. She's
the
original.
First Poison Ivy. She was the OG.
Yeah,
Poison
she was the
Ivy.
And then it was
Poison
then
Ivy.
It was Alyssa Milano.
Yes.
Yeah, but that's but Drew.
And then it was Icebox from Little Giants.
I don't even begin to know what
that's
that
too
means.
Far.
Icebox.
No,
remember Little Giants? The movie Little Giants?
Yeah.
The girl that played like the tomboy.
Nope.
She went in Poison Ivy 3.
Oh,
guys,
no.
I had a lot of lonely nights in high school.
Wow.
All right, here we go. Let's go to the next one.
24 Legacy.
I'm on board. Sign me up. Dr. Dre and 24 Legacy?
Nope. No. Bored.
Dr. Dre. I just never really watched 24. So.
We watched the trailer and I was like, bleh.
Oh, yeah. I remember it was on our trailer preview and we all didn't like
it. Was like a clip.
You and Claire.
Yeah, it was a
did
clip.
Because
yeah.
I'm the only one I can trust.
Well, nope. I'm going to give it a chance because I like Straight Outta Compton so much, but maybe 24 Legacy.
Legion on FX.
Oh, come on. That's what I think we're all just getting psyched for Legion. Yeah.
Girls on HBO.
Yes!
It's finally over.
Stop it! Jerk. Making notes in the thing. I can't wait. I love Girls. February 12th. Me and you, baby.
I love Girls in general. I don't like the
I
show.
Love that show. I hated it. I hated it. I wrote an article for NBC called A Woman Against Girls, and it has really come around. It's beautifully written. It's so well acted. I love it.
Did you write another article and apologize?
No, because I'd already laughed. I was over at FX, so I was like, suck it.
Suck it.
Big Little Lies on HBO.
Ooh, this one. Every time I get a trailer, I think I'm more interested.
And I feel like every time I get a trailer, I'm like, I know exactly how this is going to play out. I'll do the thing that I did before. I'll write out what I think is going
to
happen, and then we'll see if I'm right or
it's
not.
Not easy to live
I don't
on
remember
the beach,
this one.
You know,
it's
Shailene Woodley and Nicole Kidman and Reese Witherspoon, and there's like a murder. And
it's all like
all...
real Clint Eastwood-y like filter.
And there's affairs.
Oh wait, this
and
is
scandal.
The Reese Witherspoon led one, right?
Yeah.
I did see a trailer.
Okay.
Look good.
Next,
Billions on Showtime.
Yes. I'm the only one that watches it here.
No, I watched the first 6 episodes. I just never got back to it, but I enjoyed what I saw. I love, you know, Paul Giamatti and
David.
Good. Yeah.
What? You can't just say I watched it and then not finish the season.
Well, I mean, I just got sighted. There's a lot of TV.
Okay, all right, I'll give it to you.
I gotta watch my British
he
television
He has like
shows.
7 hours of The Expanse premiering.
I know.
He has the Crown and Victoria. Yeah. He was busy.
Which I've seen both.
Yeah. Okay, what's next?
All right, Crashing on HBO.
That's the Pete Holmes pilot that's been in development. He wrote this like 6 years
with
ago.
With Judd Apatow directing.
He talked about it on his podcast, mm-hmm. and then he got the Pete Holmes show on TBS, which kind of failed. And then, you know, he's been trying to get, and then they just launched his stand-up special.
Yeah.
And then they're going to do like another excerpt of the stand-up special leading into Crashing. I think it looks hysterical. Okay. Yeah.
Sasha, by the way, did you ever get back on The Crown and just watch like the pilot?
I never watched any.
Wow. Schnepp loves it now.
He's you like, watch
no,
the pilot?
He told me. Schnepp really likes it now.
It's pretty good.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Okay, Sinead.
Taken, NBC. Ugh.
No.
It's Rollo. Why?
What?
Rollo from
Vikings.
Yeah. Rollo's
but why do a Taken show? The movies are already great, except for the second two.
Why do they just stop it? Just stop.
Okay.
National Treasure.
This isn't about the movies, though. This is about like a. It's a British show that came over here.
Oh,
and
can't wait.
Wait, it came over here like they're just re-airing it.
Well, it's a British show that they're re-airing over here, and it's it's a comedy about a dude that's supposed to be like a national treasure, but he's an asshole.
Mm. Oh wait.
On Hulu.
I did see the preview.
Yeah. I bet it's going to be real fun. I think it's going to be really fun.
I feel like I saw the preview like this morning.
Yeah.
Interesting. All right. Iron Fist.
Well, we all know where we sit on this.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Iron Fist, yes.
Yes.
Idiot Sitter on Comedy Central.
Yes.
This is from the girl from Workaholics.
Well, this is second season.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's coming back. I like this show.
Me too.
It's really silly, but fun. All right.
Great news on NBC. NBC.
Yeah,
all great news.
This is Tina Fey. Tina Fey coming back to NBC, so I have high hopes for
And Tracy Wigfield is the star of it, and she won an Emmy for writing for 30 Rock, and 30 Rock is one of my favorite shows of all time.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I'm psyched about this
I hope this is good.
Yeah, it's like news radio, too, but better.
Yeah, that's my hope.
All right.
The Handmaid's Tale.
Yes!
I was just putting this in for David. Yep, he's feeling it.
Is it Elizabeth Moss or Kate Moss?
Elizabeth Moss. Kate Moss?
Kate Moss
is the model.
Oh, yeah. Elizabeth Moss. Yeah, she has like this like, outfit on. It's like this red outfit. It's like a nun. It looks great. Yeah.
There you go.
She's in costume. It looks great. Tale.
And finally, David's favorite.
I don't, you're
going to watch it because our fans are demanding you watch
it. You are absolutely. Stop pretending like you weren't going to watch
no,
it.
No, this is season two. I watched half Sense8. Of the first episode and I was like, and just kind of. Yeah,
maybe I'll watch it to please the fans. Guys,
no
you're welcome.
Way.
Okay, fine.
What about The Deuce? We didn't talk about The Deuce. I'm excited for that on HBO.
Oh yeah,
that's gonna be awesome.
Did I not put that in?
That's James Franco and Maggie Gyllenhaal.
Oh. Also, we got to include American Gods.
American Gods is gonna be huge.
It's not for a little while.
It's April.
Is it April? Oh, my bad on that one.
Yeah. Oh, you stopped in March. I'm sorry.
I can't wait for that.
You stopped in May. Oh, sorry.
My bad.
I thought Sense8 was new. How come I've never heard of it before? Yeah.
No, it's big. That's like, if you look in the comments every week, people say, "How come you guys talk about Sense8?" And I feel bad.
They had a Christmas special.
They did have a Christmas special.
I saw that when I queued up Trollhunters.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bang, bang.
I did not watch it.
Yeah.
And also, we have to talk briefly before we go on to the highs and lows, which are quick this time. Our Bachelor preview, because it is tonight. Now, I know David, this is going to be your first season watching The Bachelor, so you're really excited.
Whoa, I didn't commit to that.
Yeah, David, just, are you kidding me?
How many episodes is The Bachelor? It's like 20-something?
No!
I don't have time to watch The Bachelor.
It's like David,
it's not enough, is what it is.
Here's the thing about The Bachelor is you can DVR it, fast forward through most of it, and still get the gist.
Yeah.
And you get the funny drama, you get the
The Bachelor. This is with the guy, girls are trying to date the
That's correct. Right. Yes. You get all the girls trying
AKA
to love the man.
Best TV show
yeah,
ever.
The drama is incredible.
When does it start?
We should have Tonight. Amanda come on an episode of, sure. of TV Talk.
Yep.
Well, but that's just going to be after Jason, too, because
Jason loves
The Bachelor.
Ooh, little couples. Maybe we'll do like a season recap with couples.
Yes, please,
Ooh, man.
Well,
okay, so here's what we're going to do. Everybody, after tonight's elimination, we're all going to have the list of the thing, and we're going to do a draft. Like a fantasy football draft. You're all going to get to pick until we run out of picks. And whoever picks the winner at the end of the season gets a bottle of champagne.
So you want us to do, like, who's going to win, who's the runner-up, like, that way? Or just, like, the last remaining five in any order?
No. You draft your people. If in your five people that you draft, or four people, however many we get, you pick the winner, you win.
So the way my league does it, because I NPS, I have won the last two seasons.
Oh, I'm in another
in
league.
Yeah.
I got second this year.
You have to pick who's going to go out fifth, fourth, third, second, and who's going to win. Mm, and you get points based on how long they stay in.
Mm. We just go balls to the wall, one and only. So what do you think? Should we just do that?
Kareen's going to win. Blondie is taking it all away.
But you don't get her in the draft. You may not get her in the draft.
No. I'm taking her right now in this moment.
You can't
Kareen's
do
winning.
That.
I've also got Raven. I think she's going far.
That's not how the draft works.
And I'm pretty sure.
You're going against the game, Sasha. This is an OA. You can't just like hate on it immediately. Okay? You're going to do the draft. You pick out name. It's fine. I'll run it next week. We'll do it. It's fine.
Sweet. Because I have no idea what you're talking about, but I'm excited about
it. You're like the best show ever. And right
Nick,
now. This isn't real.
Nick
this
coming back.
I must be dreaming. I'm dreaming.
Honestly.
I'm dreaming.
I have
fourth
all
time's
of the
charm,
feelings.
David. Fourth
he
time.
He's always
is the
been
charm.
My favorite. Always. I loved him from the second I saw him on TV.
He
from
was
the
such
second.
A whiny little douche
no,
until Batch
him.
In Paradise.
No.
He's gotten him. Better with each ab. He's
Let's
revealed.
Move on to high lows.
Yes.
I can't wait to see his abs. I'm super excited.
Yeah,
can't wait
he
to
lives
see meltdowns.
Like right here. I'm
he's
still
going to be
nice.
So shirtless. Okay, let's do an over under. Shirtless within the first 90 seconds.
Hell
of the
yeah.
Show.
It's going to be when he's
yeah,
introducing
gonna,
himself.
Yeah, running. He's going to be running on the
beach. Always running.
Shirtless. Totally.
Always running.
So over under. Shirtless in the first 90 seconds or first 30 seconds?
90.
No. It's
so
going to be the
take
first
30,
shot we
60
see
or 90. So you're taking
besides,
30.
They're going to show what they're going to do. I'm calling right now. What they're going to do is they're going to recap his history on The Bachelor.
Oh, so you'll see him shirtless at some point.
Yeah. So they're going to recap his history, like all the times he's lost at love, right? Which has been like way too many times. And then it's going to be like, the music will change. It'll be brighter, and it's going to talk about his hope for finding
and
love
he's gonna
this
run
time.
On the beach.
And he's going to be running on the beach in Santa Monica.
Totally.
We're going to see the Ferris wheel in the background.
100%.
And he's going to be shirtless.
Okay, but at and what sweating. Point in the show? Give me a time.
I'm
time
saying
stamp.
45 seconds.
45 seconds. What are you taking?
I'm going to say 23 seconds.
I'm going to take, I'll take the over. I'll give him 71 seconds.
Whoa, right. Okay.
71
okay.
seconds of the show.
Went to
even. I might
there
have
we
just
go.
Eaten
I have
it.
No idea what you guys are talking about.
It's, we're just
no
talking about the
idea.
Best show on television, David
oh
Griffin.
Goodness. Okay, here you go.
The scissors
I know,
now.
Sorry. Sinead, take it.
Now. All right, highs and lows, you guys. You ready?
Let's
ready.
Burn Let's
take
burn
it, kicking it off strong. Mariah Carey effed up so bad.
That's the high.
On New Year's Eve, it is the biggest high on television, but I will say, was so sad and just like, pathetic on so many levels. I
awesome.
Felt so bad for her.
There you go.
I felt so bad for her backup dancers, especially the one that was like guiding her around the stage.
It was awesome. I loved it.
You know, it's awful. Whatever.
All right, let's go. Burn.
Rick and Morty, new footage.
I'm so excited.
When is the show
three.
Coming out? It's
supposed season, to be... I know. We don't even have a release date yet. I'm so excited.
Did anybody watch The Mick?
I did. Here's the thing. It was one. It was an episode of Always Sunny in Philadelphia. It was a standalone episode of Caitlin Olsen doing her character from Always Sunny. I don't know where the show goes, and I really don't care.
Oh.
The kid to play the kid from the Peter Pan commercial is funny.
Great.
I like him.
Yeah.
What happened?
Oh, and the crime show.
Yeah,
we watched.
The girl from the
night
of.
Night
she's, yeah, she's in it.
Oh,
she's the one that gets murdered.
Yeah, she's in it too.
It's funny, but it's a standalone episode of Always Sunny. I don't know if I really.
I don't know if it has
it.
Like staying power,
yeah.
But. I enjoyed
she's
it.
She's so
guess,
funny. Yeah. She should be in more TV, but she's so good in Always Sunny that just keep making
yeah.
seasons of that
yeah.
show.
That was funny.
Okay.
The Vikings, David.
I can't. You.
Okay, here's what we're going to do
next week.
Did you
get spoiled?
Week. No, I didn't
oh,
get spoiled.
People
okay.
were tweeting at us, like, telling us plot
no,
points.
No, I ignored it. Here's what we're going to do. Next week, I will be caught up, and we will do, a six-episode recap.
Well, they just hit their mid-season
of second
4.5
season. Yeah.
Finale. So, Vikings, I can't say things. It's all spoilers. Hopefully, Josh catches up, because it's
I
awesome.
Will. Next week, we'll talk.
Shameless season finale.
Yeah, that shed a tear on that one. That was really good. Finally, the people of Shameless seem like they're getting their stuff together. Put a little warm spot in the heart.
Casey Affleck's Dunkin' Donuts
the
sketch
funniest,
on SNL.
Best sketch in so long.
So good.
Oh, my God.
Yo, I'm the face of Dunkin'.
I come in and get a crawl. Coffee, take a dump.
Three parliaments, take a huge dump. Oh, it's so
it
good.
Genius.
You got to watch it. Yeah. David, you haven't seen the Casey Affleck Dunkin'?
I'm not really an SNL guy.
You don't
oh,
have
no,
to be. This
just
is like,
this
it's, good.
It's
so
the
good.
Okay. Casey Affleck
I'll check it out.
Dunkin' Donuts sketch. So I was crying. I watched it like four times.
I watched it.
It's hilarious.
We already talked a little about this, but the promos for Taboo. Yeah, awesome. The Return of Will and Grace.
Yeah,
is anybody asking for this?
I don't understand why this is happening. No,
member berries.
Member berries.
Member Will and Grace. Oh, yeah. I'm
member. It's Leah Remini's Scientology series.
Yo. Yeah.
This series just scares me.
If you are
so
not watching this show, uncomfortable. It's brilliant.
It makes
and
me like
so addictive.
It's, yeah, it's just like gross.
But the fact
but
that
it's so
also,
good.
She's willing. That she Leah Remini is an American treasure. She's willing
she
to go
sure
to the
is.
Mattresses. She is so down to be like, this is the truth. I am standing up for it. This is wrong. This is not how families should be. This is not how a corporation should be run. It is brilliant. And if you live in LA, her husband owns a great restaurant called Vivian's, and they have a thing called the Otis, and it is tuna patties with scrambled eggs and cheese, and it's the bomb.
Nice.
I love that place. And the all best right. banana pancakes.
Let's move on. Let's just move on to Twitter questions. Wait, do we want to get
we
to
talk
the...
about Ronda Rousey? This is about
UFC.
Ronda
Rousey
got knocked out. It's a bummer.
No, but that was
Guys, let's get your Twitter questions. They've been asking us all over
Ronda
the break.
Ronda Rousey, super low.
Dr. Foster, real quick, is any good?
Dr. Foster is dope.
Okay. Traveler's Pilot. Did anybody, you watch Traveler's? Was it good?
Travelers was okay.
Okay. Travelers, okay. Let's
you
go.
Heard it first.
Twitter questions, hashtag at Collider TV Talk. Thank you guys for always tweeting in. We will do an all like a heavy Twitter question episode at some point in 2017. This, I promise you. Sinead, what's next?
At iCrazyDavy says, if CW asks you to pick one more superhero to air on Friday nights and be part of the Flaroverse, who would you pick?
I'm Batman. Give me a Batman show, not Gotham. I know it's not going to happen, but...
I would like Batgirl. We've got Supergirl. Ooh. Let's do Batgirl.
Okay.
Nightwing.
Ooh, Nightwing. All in the Batman
All in the Batman. I know we're not going to get it.
I was going to say Batman, but now I want to be like Sasha and change it to Batgirl.
Okay.
Do it, girl.
Boom. Nice. Batgirl, Nightwing, side. Any of them. Yep. All right, Sinead.
Matthew says, which of the CW superheroes would you want to hang out with?
Dude, by far, Cisco on The Flash. Guy's funny. He's really smart. He could like make a weapon to make things cool. And then like he's a sick wingman. Chicks don't love him, but he's like so lovable. The girl's like, oh, he's funny. And then you get, you know, you hang out with Cisco. Sick.
I would just hang out with The Flash.
I'm engaged,
like,
by the way.
Yeah, I hang out with like the, well, I hang out with like the side dude when you can hang out with the number one. I
yeah, but
Flash.
He can vibe and be like, oh, she doesn't like you. Like, moving on.
Yeah, but I don't need that. I'm already married, and I'd rather, you know, just stare at Grant Gustin's very handsome face.
That's true. All right. Sinead?
Yeah, I'd probably do The Flash as well, just because I feel like I have the most chance of dating him.
Griff?
I'm hanging out with my boy Diggle.
Oh, Diggs.
No Diggs. I'm hanging out with Diggle.
He's a human being. He shoots guns. Yeah. Love it. All right, Sinead, what's next?
Unknown Gamer says, what show should air new episodes daily?
Ooh.
Good Lord. Like, if I would love to see, like, on Adult Swim, how they have the 11-minute episodes. Mm. I'd love to go back to, like, almost a magazine-style show, 11 minutes of a Peaky Blinders or a Sopranos or some kind of, like, family drama that's real quick. You're getting a snippet each
Don't like the Adult
day.
Swim shows. Like, didn't, like, Aqua Teen Hunger Force and that was big? Didn't that kind of, like, air, like, at least Monday
like
through
six
Friday?
Six or seven weeks for on a day.
Yeah, they do that. Yeah. So some shows do. I think it works better with not hour-long dramas, but I think it works better with smaller episodes.
Because then you're just getting into like a soap opera. Yeah. I will say, I don't want it to air daily, but the show that I am missing the most right now is Pitch. Oh my goodness,
Pitch
guys.
Was
that
so
show
good.
Was so good.
That finale was awesome.
Did it get renewed?
Man, I don't think so. Not yet, but God, I love it. Pitch is the best.
If it goes down and it doesn't get renewed, it's going to be like a Freaks and Geeks for me because it ends so shockingly tragic. Oh, man. All right, Shanest.
UFC fan says, what TV character would be acceptable to bring home to your parents as a significant other?
Well, the one that I would want to bring, because she seems like the funniest, is Fleabag, but my parents would hate her.
I wish just you'd not take her home to meet Mrs. McCouga.
Wow. No, she would hate it.
I mean, my parents are crazy stoner hippies, so I like because you brought up the cast of Workaholics. Yeah. I'm like, my parents would love any of those
dudes. Yeah, yeah,
like, they, we would have the best time.
Yes, David.
Mine would be Claire Randall.
Ah.
Katrina Belfay. That's how you say her name. It's not Catrione, which is really disappointing. But okay. Yeah, I would take her. Outlander, of course.
Oh,
yeah.
There you
she's
go.
Classy. She's educated.
Always bringing that Outlander back. Mm. I mean, I'd obviously bring Mother of Dragons.
Do you
but
watch
they would
Outlander?
Eat our dogs, I probably.
Do. Oh, you do watch
Yeah. It. Sinead, who are you taking home?
The DJ from Backstage.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God. That's so Jackson.
Little young.
A little
young.
They're literally 10 years old. You would take the hot one with the guitar and the versatile issues?
No.
All right.
He's too lame.
Final question.
He's hot.
Hunter says, who would you cast as each other in a TV talk movie?
Okay. For
like
Sinead.
Based on looks?
Well,
or personality?
I think it's got to be a little bit of both.
You going to say Zoe Kravitz?
Yeah. Or Vanessa Hudgens.
Vanessa Hudgens.
She's got a lot of spunk, and she's really beautiful.
Well, they're
like
both
you,
beautiful.
So
both
good.
Girls are beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah. I feel like Zoe Kravitz is too in herself.
Yeah.
Yeah. I can
see.
Zoe's
a little like sass.
Vanessa Hudgens makes sense.
Vanessa.
Okay. Okay.
Vanessa
All right.
Hudgens.
All right. Mm-hmm.
David Griffin.
David Griffin would be. Okay. Wait. Hold on. Let's think about
Here
this.
Comes.
David Palmer, President David Palmer, in the first season of 24.
Oh.
You got that nice
but he's
baritone.
Too old. He's too old.
He's a little too old.
He's a little too. I wish I had that voice. I got that.
We need somebody a little younger.
But it's like someone super dignified.
Yeah.
You know.
Somebody
I'm like, yeah.
Like
wait,
Lawrence
why can't it
Fishburne.
Be the dude who plays Luke Cage?
He was young.
Oh, Mike Coulter.
Yeah, why not Mike Coulter?
No.
Yeah. Oh, why? No, the beard.
Like, no, but he's like my he still has like a colder
Michael
Kenneth exterior.
Williams?
Chuck Michael White. Kenneth
no.
Williams? These two
Michael B. Jordan. Dark. Michael B. Jordan.
Yeah.
Michael B. Jordan. Classy, yeah. Dignified, but also like very warm.
Yes. Yeah. Totally.
Sasha Paul Raber, I would see Caitlin Olsen. Like super funny, bubbly, hysterical, could carry a comedy or a drama.
Queen of Shade?
Yeah, Queen of Shade.
Sinead's
sure.
like,
mm-hmm. still thinking.
Yeah. I like to see, I know it's going to be a bit of a long shot, but I like to see January Jones.
Whoa, Whoa. But I'm not Ice Queenie. She's very Ice Queenie.
She sure is. Let's go ahead. Who do you guys think is going to be me? Oh, Sinead still hasn't said.
Macuga. Oh,
man. Who's a Macuga? Macuga might be one of a kind.
That's no. Who we got?
Who's going to play?
Because then I got a pick of the week.
It's got to be someone who's kind of neurotic, right? So then.
What do you got, like David
what if
Schwimmer?
We get, like, that's exactly what I was going to say.
What if, like, what if Jonah Hill lost weight?
Again?
That's a real. I don't know about that.
What if Miles Teller gained weight?
Oh, burn! Nice one, Sasha. I had a little too much to eat over the holidays, so
no.
I got to be shedding for this wedding.
No, Miles Teller is like a little scrawny boy.
Wait, you're not getting married like anytime soon.
No. But you know, start shedding for the wedding.
Shia LaBeouf before he went crazy.
Ooh.
Shia LaBeouf was so good in American Honey.
Yeah, also he has that like kind of neurotic-y.
Yeah.
For
you don't
sure.
look like him exactly, but I feel like he could play you.
He would go super method.
He could be Macuga.
Gotcha.
Shia LaBeouf is Macuga.
Okay. Yeah. All right. I'll take Shia LaBeouf. All right, finally, fans have been asking for it, so I have this balloon.
Death Star.
It's the pick of the week. It's my pick.
Love
starting
it.
Off 2017. My brother and I watched a ton of Dukes of Hazzard over the holiday break. I love the Dukes of Hazzard. Now, the General Lee is a bit racist, but I love this show. 79 to 85 gave us Daisy Dukes, gave us the brothers. It's Boss Hogg. It's so much fun. You guys can find it streaming. You can get it on Amazon. Do yourself a favor and go watch an American classic of just country folk doing stupid stuff.
It's literally like pretty racist, though. Yeah. So don't take it like personally.
Yeah,
if you haven't seen it and you're wondering why Josh recommended a super racist show.
It's not super racist.
It has a lot of undertones.
Does it? All right, my bad on that one.
It's also like, is there a Confederate
flag? Yeah, I mean,
that's why I said it's a little racist.
Their entire theme of the show is
Be
like,
careful. I've heard some people say like, oh, I'm really fond of the romanticism of the old South. I'm like, yeah, like slavery?
I'm romanticizing about is them jumping cars. That's all I ever wanted to
and
do.
And hot chicks.
Hot chicks and
Daisy.
Jumping cars. That'll do it for us for our first episode here of 2017 on Collider TV Talk. Before we get out of here, where can the good people find you? Sinead DeVries.
I'm online at Sinead DeVries and at thatsosinead.com. We're back, which is awesome. Awesome. I miss you guys, especially you, Sasha.
Yeah.
Mostly just because I haven't seen her in long.
Yeah,
but you guys can find me on Mondays here with these guys, on Fridays doing movie talk and then hosting a mailbag over the weekend.
David Edward Griffin, Sir David Edward Griffin.
Sir David Griffin, I was knighted. You can find me at GriffinDE on Twitter and Instagram. Also, we have a huge, huge Star Wars Rebel double episode this week. You know, we're post Rogue One. It's a big time for Star Wars fans. Check that out with Christian and John Campia on Saturdays.
Sasha Pearl Raver.
Queen of Shade can be found at Sasha Pearl Raver on Instagram and Twitter. I am hosting FX Movie Download every Friday on FX, and I'm going to be tweeting a lot about The Bachelor.
Oh, yeah.
Get it in. Best show on television.
So excited for The Bachelor. This will be our first season doing it. If you guys don't like The Bachelor, get into it. Watch the mayhem with us. I guarantee you, you'll be somewhat entertained. I know David Griffin is apprehensive, but he'll sign on. I'm Josh Macuga, at Josh Macuga on Twitter and Instagram, The Josh Macuga Show on YouTube. TV Talk every Monday. Awesome Tacular on Go 90. You guys, I'm just having a schmodown, all that kind of fun stuff. I really want to thank you all for watching the Golden Remotes in our year interview, and we really did miss you, Sasha, on those. It was not the same without you.
Sorry, I had to hang with The Rock.
I'm so excited. Yeah. I'm so excited for what 2017 has to bring us in television. But as always, put down the book, pick up the remote.
Hey guys, if you like this video, click the thumbs up button. Also, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. It'll help you stay up to date with everything we've got going on here at Collider.